Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this morning is Punit Dhillon, CEO at Skye Bioscience. Punit, good to see you again. How are you?
Good morning. Great seeing you again too. Thanks for taking the time to always learn about what we're doing at Skye.
Of course, it's very interesting stuff. We did see that Skye recently announced an expansion of the Cannabinoid Pharmaceutical Innovation Program with a few different research organizations. Can you tell us a bit more about the importance of some of these agreements?
Yeah, so there's a few important takeaways there, Christine. We've entered into new research agreements with the University of Eastern Piedmont in Italy and the Spanish Research Council. The idea here is to focus on developing an extensive library of novel molecules that are designed to really modulate the endocannabinoid system. The initial focus is going to be on ophthalmic disorders, but the other important takeaway here is that there's any collaborations that we're doing on the academic side, or we're working towards industry collaborations as well, is really intended to build and establish this larger screening library that we want to have. We're targeting up to about 100 molecules in the first year, and this is meant for us to continue to build on that, so we can screen them using our proprietary screening platform that's been developed by Skye. So the idea here is to analyze all of these different potential molecular targets that are really geared towards seeing how that affects any particular disease pathways in the ophthalmology setting. And the other side of it is continuing to build on that engine and expand on the intellectual property side and ultimately the pipeline and clinical candidates that we want to continue to explore at Skye. So, I think if you take a step back, we want to position Skye as a leader in really understanding the science around the endocannabinoid system and continue to explore the different therapeutic pathways. So the work that we're doing in the CPIP is really geared towards that. The significance of it is to show that differentiation in the intellectual property and then build that pipeline of molecules and continue to show how they're unique and chemically distinct and patentable, and all of our drugs that we're developing right now are synthetically manufactured, which is a big difference in terms of compared to the natural compounds out there.
Thanks for explaining that to us. Separately, we did speak not too long ago about the proposed merger between Skye and Emerald Health Therapeutics. Can you maybe just update us on how things are progressing there?
Yeah, so that's definitely a very important transaction for both companies' shareholders. It provides clear directionality towards the value creation plan that we have set out at Skye, especially given the current kind of market volatility and the overall tightening of the capital market. So we're working towards completing that transaction. Currently, we're waiting on Emerald to file updated financials, which that are being completed. That once that's complete, it allows us to file the proxy statement and information circular that's required for shareholder approval. And the expected timeline to get that done is approximately late Q3, early Q4 in terms of wrapping up our shareholder meeting.
All right, excellent. We'll follow up on that. And then before I let you go, the company is set to launch its first in-human clinical trial to treat glaucoma in Australia. When can we expect that to begin?
Yeah, that's been I appreciate everyone's been really patient on that, including the company. We've been waiting patiently for kind of the process to complete on the HREC. A submission was made to HREC, that's the ethics committee in Australia, in early March. We've been in active correspondence with regards to questions and comments that have come up. And that's pretty typical for new drugs being used in a new application. So we don't see any major concerns, but it's a process that does take time, and we're working through that process with our principal investigator in Australia to conclude it. So we're confident that that's going to be done and there's going to be a positive response. Once we get that approval, then we'll make an announcement regarding that effect. After the ethics committee approval, there are a few additional steps required before we begin the enrollment. That's the clinical trial notification with the Australian TGA, We're also required to secure an export permit before we from DEA before we deliver the drug in Australia. And then there's the site initiation and training, but that's all kind of the customary steps required for us to begin the trial. And everything's contingent on us getting the HREC approval first. So we're just going to deal with that and get that out of the way first, and then we'll get the trial started.
Well, we definitely really appreciate you updating us on all of those initiatives today. Punit, thank you so much.
Thank you, Kim.